I'm living a more carefree, simple life, you know? I'm not living beyond my means at all. And I'm just trying to do the right thing and think about something that my partner Ronnie told me. And, you know, every decision that you make in your life, you know, he saw my son give me a hug, and he said, think about that time when your son gave you the hug every time you make a dumb decision, you know what I mean, before you make it. So that's a good gauge.
Now, I mean, at one point you went to rehab.
Yeah, one time.
One time. How long were you in rehab at the time?
Well, at the time, it seemed like forever, but it was a, you know, in care and then out care, like a total of like 2.5, 3 months.
Okay. And how much did that experience really change you?
I mean, it changed a lot. It was a reality check, and you know, when you're that far gone, you don't realize how far gone you are. You know, you swear to God that you're still fine and you're right, and then looking back after you clear up, and you get some, get some time under your belt sober, you start realizing like, oh my God, was I like that person? And people would come up to you and say, yo, I feel like I'm talking to somebody different. What can I say? You know, that's life. It's hard being a kid that, I was a semi-nerd at some point in my early life and didn't come from money. And, you know, all of a sudden you're faced with every option to do anything you want to do. People are throwing women drugs and jewelers are like pushers too. Like the jewelers would come around like pushing, you know, it wasn't like sometimes I would even go out looking for things and it was like trouble would find me. And, you know, when you're weak like that, you make stupid decisions. So it was lesson learned. But I feel like I'm not old yet, and I'm still able to do my thing, and hopefully everybody likes a good comeback, and people support me, and show love, and remember, you know, all the time that I spent delivering the world good music, and you know what I mean, and you know, I think I deserve my place in music history, and I think I deserve for the world to recognize that, you know, I went through what I went through, and if I hurt some people in my life, I'm sorry for that. But I have to take the reins and you know, I'm not gonna stop. I'm gonna make the best music I can make now, and I'm fiending for that number one spot now, not the drugs.
Lil Wayne had just put out an interview or statement saying like he didn't like New York.
I just don't like New York.
And you know, I mean, it's his opinion to say.
Ever since I met Stephen, when he pissed me off, fucking bitch ass, faggot ass nigga, but that's how we talk in Miami. And I'm trying to work on that because I actually, my brother's gay.